izle. Originally, I'm an electronic engineer. I'm an inventor. I like to solve problems. I see myself as a creative person. I designed several products, sold almost 1 million pieces around the world, mostly in USA, Europe, also in Japan. I would like to talk about mining. So the last 2 years, I shift from designing consumer electronic products to run mining facilities in Asia, mostly in Kazakhstan and in Sichuan area in China. I have a question for you guys. Raise hand, please, if you have any experience with mining. Try to see. I would say maybe less than 10 people. So, not so much. It's not a secret that the mining industry in Japan is completely destroyed, I would say. Some people say it's because the electricity price is affecting dramatically the profit of the mining firm, and it was too high. But it's not the only reason. The reason is lack of education. The mining industry, people try to win each other, try to have more harsh power, to be bigger than each other, sell more. There's not enough education, it's a pretty young industry. And this is why we came up with conclusions. How to educate the investors and save the money. Around $10 billion invested around the world in digital mining in the last 5 years. And most of the investors didn't see our eye back. They didn't see the money back. Most of them do not see the mining back, they just try to sell their facilities, their mining activities, their mining equipment. And it's a shame. Instead of investing in good projects, good technologies, people that invested in hardware, it's very hard to liquidate. Just an example of some information that most investors that invested in mining didn't even look at money. A big blocker for the entire mining industry is 12.5 Bitcoin every 10 minutes. It equals to 1,800 Bitcoin every day. Equals to $9 billion or $1 billion every day. It means all the mining, the Bitcoin mining in the world need to share $9 billion a day. It doesn't matter how many miners are connected. We count around 4 million miners around the world, and all of them need to share $9 million right now. This chart you can see that from May 18th to September 18th, the hash rate jumped almost twice. It means that the amount of miners multiplied by two, and the miners had to split to share half of the block reward. If an investor, regular investor in mining, would think about the trends, what would happen if the Bitcoin go up and immediately he wants to buy one machine, if he would care about the trend, he would be more smart, and he might not even invest in the miners. Another problem with the trend that we've seen is that the mining facilities with more funds, with money, try to increase their operation and they buy smaller mining activities. They buy the miners, they take it to more efficient places with cheaper electricity. And the trend is that eventually, in 5 to 7 years, someone will own, can own more than 51% of the hash power in the world. And anyone here, please raise hand if you know what is 51% attack on a blockchain. I would say 5 to 10%. So for us, us, Bitcoin is one of the most important projects in coins because no one can control it. But the trend that we see, if someone will own more than 51% of the Bitcoin, they actually can control the Bitcoin. They can manipulate the transactions. They can send one Bitcoin to two wallets. They can reject transaction or try to take the money back before 24 hours. What happens then? Bitcoin is not safe. Bitcoin is not transparent. It's not democratic anymore. The softer people think about the democracy. The harder people think about the hardware risk and coming from the hardware. So the cheapest way to protect it is the World Digital Mining Organization. I'm happy to announce about this day for the first time. This is a new organization. I'm the temporary chairman because I want to do it transparent and fair. So once we will do events and consensus meetings, we will also vote for chairman and policies. What is it all about? It's about education, information, long-term industry. If you give information, you will not tell people what to do. You just educate them, they can take smart decisions. The idea is not to buy as many mining machines right away. You need to understand, to learn more, and also only if you have great conditions for profitable business, like cheap electricity, or you can buy the mining equipment in the low cost, but this is like a bear market. Today, if a mining farm has 3 to 5 cents, US dollar, per kilowatt per hour, it's a profitable business. You can find it in some places in Asia and North America, but not in Japan, Korea, and most of the countries in the world. We welcome people to register now for free, and we motivate them with free information. But what we really want is that to build together a policy. And in this policy, we can do simple things like simple rules saying, I will not manipulate with my equipment the Bitcoin network. Or I will not sell my equipment to someone that is not a member of digital mining. So we will do a lot of events, a lot of noise about it. We will meet the biggest manufacturers of equipment, we think together of a quality standard, consensus, long term, keep the industry regulated, stable, maybe sometimes smaller, but for the long term. And not bigger, and then you lose your money after half a year. So people asking us what to invest in, hotel or mining. We look at the mining trend. If you don't have cheap equipment and low-cost electricity, it's better to invest in hotel. But if you do have the right conditions, on the bottom you can see in the blue, it's always more profitable than hotel. So what to invest in? Of course, mining, I say it's mining, but only if you do it right. Is it good time to invest in mining? Mining's cost now is low, produce Bitcoin before next bullish market is possible, and high chance to attempt investment and much more. Is it a good time to invest in Bitcoin mining? It's the best time to invest in Bitcoin mining. For disclosure, I'm the CEO also of Mindvest. Mindvest, we build big mining facilities from 100 megawatts an hour, hosting 100,000 miners an hour. And we care about our clients, our investors. So the first idea was to protect ourselves from long-term business and keep our clients hosting in our facilities. Some pictures, but it's already been built right now in Kazakhstan, and all of you guys are invited to get more information in our booth, Magnus booth, also about digital mining. And I hope I educated some of you a little bit, so enjoy the rest of the day. Thank you so much.